The home of the 12s. They raised the banner just a moment ago. We are set for football at Lumen Field here a mile south of downtown Seattle. Tyler Bass about ready to get us going.
And off we go from Seattle.
And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line.
The Seattle now ready to march onto the field. Let's give them a show.
Smith going to look to throw right away. Open man, that's Noah Fant, the tight end.
And he gets this up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds.
4 yards the result on the first play from scrimmage. Second down.
That was a nice throw out there to the flat, but they defended that pretty well. The hope is to go ahead and put it on him so he can turn and get upfield and gain additional yardage. It just wasn't anywhere to go on that play.
And that throw behind his man, he missed him, incomplete.
They'll put a check mark in the box where the defense coordinator was saying, how well can we stay with these receivers if we're in man coverage? Because he just did it on that one, forced the incompletion. That allowed him to get bolder with his pass rush, won't it?
Absolutely, frees up your guys elsewhere. This defense looking for an early stop. This is third down and 6. Now Geno.
Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he is going to have a Seahawks first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Well, I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
They'll run. It's Kenneth Walker.
And give him about 5 as he gets this up to the 48-yard line.
That's a really good gain right there. They pick up 5 yards halfway to a first down. The only problem now in the huddle, everyone's going to want to touch the football. Be a lot of chattering now because they've seen that they can move the line of scrimmage.
Second and 5. Sticking with Walker on second down.
And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. 23 yards on the pickup there and a first. Couple of nice carries back-to-back here, establishing the ground game a bit.
Yeah, these aren't bare-bones runs now. I mean, they're getting substantial yardage, the kind of yards you're looking for, right? Let's go ahead and use a cliche. Stay ahead of the change, right? Five or more yards each time. That's what you're looking for in setting a tone and getting your offensive line going.
Good sign on the opening drive.
A quick throw knocked away. It's incomplete.
Yeah, their back's up against the wall a little bit, and they come through by forcing an incompletion. Now they've got to continue to ratchet up the intensity a couple of more times and get off the field before giving up any more yardage.
Smith, an incomplete pass on first down. Now it's 2nd and 10. Throwing now is Geno. He'll lock it with a grab over the middle.
And he's got a first down as a tackle made at the Bills' 12-yard line.
It'll be a gain of 16 for number 16.
What a drive this has been, just chewing up the yardage. And here's one of their best plays yet as they finally get down into the red zone and look to finish this off with 6.
From down at the 12, it's 1st and 10.
Here's Smith. Touchdown, Seahawks.
Noah Fant.
A 12-yard touchdown grab.
And the Seahawks are on the board first here this afternoon. A terrific opening drive has them knocking on the door, 1st and goal. Charbonnet. He is going nowhere in a hurry as he is going to lose yardage here in a big way.
That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down.
It looks like they quit hitting the snooze button on their alarm there. Finally a sign of life from this defense. They've been fairly passive on this opening drive. Now able to stand up on 1st and goal, and they sent that play backwards.
Walker
Able to get a couple here, but won't get across the plane as they stop him right around the one. Driven it down the field nicely here on the opening drive, but now it's put up or shut up.
No doubt about it, because to make that type of a drive and ultimately kick a field goal would feel very disappointing. But I'm just wondering, is the head coach thinking, is this four down territory? Might he go for it?
Now Smith on third and goal to the end zone, but it's incomplete. So it's been a long drive. They've held the ball for quite a while. Now what do you do here?
Well, to me, at this stage, after this drive, this close to the goal line, 3 points would be a letdown. I'm going for it here.
And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on fourth. They'll run for it. It's Walker. And he will take this one in for the Seattle touchdown. Kenneth Walker punching it in from a yard away. And the Seahawks' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points. I think going for it there on the opening drive, CD, if you're that close to the end zone, seems like a no-brainer, and they're able to cap things off with a touchdown.
I think that he was imagining the message he would send to his team if he called for the field goal unit at that point. Great drive, got it all the way down there. You're telling your offense, I believe in you, and you're also telling your defense, hey, if they don't score, we've got it covered.
And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. And the returner down to a knee, and this will come out to the 30-yard line. The Bills ready to take over. Allen and the Bills now with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Throwing to start the drive, Allen. And that one too wide and incomplete. Charles, already trailing by a touchdown early. This offense, how imperative is it for them to get points out of this drive?
Well, they feel like they have to go ahead and match because of what was already on the board against their defense. But I think even more so, you just want to avoid three and outs. You want to be able to stay on the field for a little while, let your defense catch their breath a little bit, even if you don't score any points.
Now Allen. He's got his man. That's the rookie from Florida State. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. 10 yards, good enough for a Buffalo first down. We'll see what kind of mindset they have here offensively after giving up the touchdown on the opening drive.
And based on our time with them, you know, prior to this game, I feel like they've got a good mindset going in. In fact, the discussion that we had with the coaching staff was, you know, we may give up some points in this game, so our offense has to be ready each and every time.
And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Uchenna and Wosu got the sack there.
But you could almost see his eyes light up defensively. I mean, as a linebacker, that's about as quick as you can get to a quarterback.
So what did your third grade teacher teach you about straight lines, right? As soon as you have those, you take full advantage of them. He found a gap in the offensive line, got to the quarterback, and put him on the deck.
Allen's throw is complete. And he gets this up to the 34 out of bounds there.
What I love about watching the passing game nowadays is that the one-dimensional receiver is really starting to leave the game. You've got to be able to do it all. Of course, you've got to run fast. Of course, you've got to catch the ball. But route running savvy and toughness, there's a premium for all of that now.
Throwing is Allen on third. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Cook. And they stop him up short of the first down as they get him at about the 43. It's a gain of 9, but it's also going to mean a punt here on their opening drive.
Brandon, it certainly looked like they had that play defended well, but it still almost worked. Got it to the running back. He wound up getting really good yardage out of it, but it was third and long, and they were able to rally and stop it before he could get to the marker.
Here's the punter, Martin, out to kick it away.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Second quarter now from Seattle, and it is the Seahawks with the football here. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They've got the 7-0 lead. Now they've got the football back after their defense got the stop, CD. And you get the feeling if they could score here, they'd really have all the momentum on their side.
And you just wonder right now, is the quarterback and the play caller totally in sync? Are they of one mind that, hey, what worked last time? Let's keep doing it until they stop us. Or do they go to a different section in the playbook, show them something different? Either way, they want a repeat of their first drive.
Smith's throw caught here by Metcalf. And they work this well upfield across the 45. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down.
And defenses go into games against Seattle understanding that DK Metcalf is someone who presents a lot of problems for them with his blend of size, speed, and physicality. And he picks up another first down there. Big play guy, topped a 1,000-yard mark in each of the previous two seasons. If he keeps making plays like that, we know he's going to have a good shot to make it three straight by the end of this season.
Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays.
They ran that one well, and not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
Walker now on first and 10. And he works his way forward to pick up 4 yards there, second down.
And that was a quality play to start a new set of downs. That was simply an offensive line winning the battle up front and winning in a big way and giving their guy in the backfield a nice lane to hit.
From the 38 now, here's second and 6. Sticking with Walker on second down. 2 yards the gain there, and now they're left with a third and about 4 for a first.
That play reminded me a lot of a former teammate of mine. We used to call him the trash man. His ability to sift through traffic and make plays was uncanny.
And that's exactly what you want from your Mike linebacker.
Third and 4. Now Smith. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he's got a first down as the tackle made at the Bills 26. Give him 10 yards there as this offense is on a roll. This drive continues to plunge forward.
Well, a lot of times when you get a manageable third down situation like this, you have to think about your tight end, and he comes through for him, picking up the first down.
Out of the gun, Walker with it. And he's able to motor his way down to the 16-yard line. 50 yards rushing now on 8 carries for him so far.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense, because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. And going right back to Walker.
5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Consecutive positive runs for him on the last two snaps. He certainly appears to be trying to put the offense on his back and just move them down the field when his number is called. The way he's running it, I'd keep going back to him.
Here's a second and 5. Now it's Smith. Being chased out left. A good decision in the end. The pull it and run gets him 9 yards and a first.
They made a nice effort to stick him with a loss for that play, but it's going to take more than that to keep him from advancing the ball. Should be an entertaining battle anytime he tucks and runs over the second half of this contest.
They'll try the air now with Smith. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone for the Seahawk touchdown. Noah Fant, a 2-yard touchdown grab. And the Seahawks go up by 2 touchdowns.
Another impressive drive. So they're two for two, two touchdowns. Charles, a great start to this ball game for them.
And one of the words that's really worked its way into our lexicon is stacking. They've stacked momentum each time out, not only on offense. Between those touchdowns, defense held, forced a punt to get the ball back, and they played awfully well in this one. Both sides playing at optimum level.
After the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away.
And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. So here come the Bills out for their second drive. And Charles, we'll see what they can do here. Not a ton of time left, but enough certainly to get points out of this drive. And they need them right now because they're trailing.
Yeah, and this is exactly why you practice a two-minute drill all through camp. And at least one practice each week before a game. A minute left, more than enough time to string a few completions together, reach the end zone, and then make that walk back to the locker room just a little more animated.
And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down, second and right at a yard. Allen trying to hurry everybody up to the line of scrimmage. Allen looks to throw on second down. And this is Cook with a grab. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Now the Bills are going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. To the air, Allen setting up the screen for Cook. Now the Bills will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Second down and 6 now. On play action, Allen. And got his man complete. That goes for a gain of 31.
So often when we're watching a football game, we see one with a lot of ebbs and flows, and this one is no different. And sometimes you just need a big play to wake you up a bit. And they get one right there. That shot of caffeine this offense was looking for.
The Bills are going to go ahead and use their final timeout, as they'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number one.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line.
To throw, it's Allen. Over the middle, the catch by Coleman.
He's going to be brought down there in the field of play, and the clock will run. No timeouts. They will not have the chance to bring out the field goal unit.
So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number 3 here.
Taking it about the 1. And he takes this near the 25, just a little pass there, call it the 26.
Out come the Bills now as they'll go on offense first here in this third quarter.
And they're still very much in this game, although they do trail. What's the game plan, Charles, for the second half?
It might be a little counterintuitive because most people will think losing equals passing the ball more, but I'd establish the running game. They kind of went away from it in the first half. I think if they get back in balance, it'll help them when they put the ball back in the air.
A throw left side to start the drive is complete. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. He continues to deliver a first down here. He had four catches in the first half, and this one number five.
A promising sign there from an offense that hasn't done a whole lot to this point. Nice job to locate the open receiver. And it's good yardage and a first down to open the drive.
Now a first carry for the brother of Dalvin. It's James Cook. Able to break through that initial contact and winds up getting about three there. It's second down.
Look, all any running back wants is a little bit of room, a little bit of space in order to maneuver. But he also understands how difficult it is for his offensive line up front. So if they give him any space, he realizes his job to make more out of it than what they give him. Picks up three on that carry.
On second down, Cook. And he swallowed up right near the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and six.
Early down stuff's to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Now Allen. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. Josh Allen, very athletic at 6'5", showing the versatility, picking up the first on the scramble.
Has not been a big game for him throwing the football. I think he feels like, let's try something different. Let's use the legs here and see if we can make some plays.
And no passing touchdowns, yardage not where he would like it. Try something new, it worked there. First down, here's the run with Cook. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
This defense is just flat getting after it. They have not given up much of anything in the run game. Case in point right there.
So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on second down and 11. Allen going to throw. He's able to get it to Coleman. And that'll wind up moving the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks' 24-yard line. They call his number again. It's his sixth catch and a first down. I don't know what they talked about at halftime. Whatever it was, it worked. They look like a different team here in the third quarter.
Yeah, I doubt that there are very many trash cans that got kicked over that type of a speech. I think what they did was they analyzed what worked in the first half, what didn't, and figured out a better game plan.
And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of nine on first down.
And I think he just wanted to get the ball to one of his playmakers to see if they can make something happen, but he ends up throwing into a crowded area. And after the catch, he isn't able to do much with it.
Second down and a yard. Back to the ground, Cook. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. The 6 yards on the pickup, and it leaves him with a first and goal.
I'm okay with the call there. In fact, I actually like it. I know they're down a couple of scores, but the running game worked in that situation. I would continue to go in that direction.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. They'll run with Cook. A solid move on the run, but ultimately stopped short of the goal line, down at the 2. A good pickup there, 7 yards, and it's going to be second and goal now.
That's good hard running right there on first and goal. That gets them down to the 2 and puts a lot more pressure on that defense.
Good yardage on first down. Now can they punch it in on second and goal? Cook is in. Touchdown, Bills.
No touchdowns for them in the first half, but their defense kept them in this ball game. So now, maybe this can loosen them up a little because they played tight so far and they get right back in it with a touchdown run.
But Tyler Bass on for the extra point attempt. And that one makes it 14-7. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. And he'll wisely just take a knee here, and this ball will come out to the 30-yard line.
Now we'll see what this Seahawks offense has in store with their first possession of the second half.
And maybe some renewed pressure on this unit following the touchdown a moment ago. It's back to a one-score game.
And because of that pressure, because it's now a one-score game, they know this is where you need to slow the momentum change, because otherwise that could overrun your team. You've got to be careful right here.
He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least two first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
They'll come up now second and four from the 31. Smith.
That's DK Metcalf running the slant. He's got it.
And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. 14 yards that time for number 14.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game, because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
Now Geno on first down.
That completes it again to Metcalf.
And he's brought down. 12 more yards for him there. It's a first down. Three quarters in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now in Seattle, Washington. It's the Seahawks with the possession. They also have the lead here as we get set for the fourth and final quarter. Play action. It's Smith. He hits his target. Lockett. And he's going to get this inside the 30. It'll be a gain of 16 for number 16.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down. Stomp down. How about that? Back-to-back completions. They are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football.
To the air again, Smith. And he's taken to the ground, but he was pulled down by the face mask. Here come the flags, and I believe this is going to be a first down. Trailing in the fourth, this close of a game, that's a penalty you just can't afford.
It's an absolute killer, and it's one that drives coaches and teammates insane.
So a big penalty there on the face mask leads to first and 10. Straight ahead, Walker. And the result here, a pickup of eight. Leaves him with two to go on second down.
If you can keep getting gains like that, Charles, with the lead here in the fourth quarter, I mean, keep running it, right?
No doubt about it. But what the offense coordinator has to do is understand they're going to continue to stack the line of scrimmage. What runs do you have in your arsenal that'll work against a stacked box and continue to move the ball?
On second down, here's Smith. And this will be caught by his big wide receiver.
And the Seahawks are going to have a first and goal as the tackle is made at about the five.
So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up.
Here's Walker.
And he'll get this one back to the 5-yard line, but no further than that. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal.
Defense simply not fooled by the draw there.
Well, they were thinking run to begin with, and what they tell their defensive linemen is, play the run on your way to the quarterback. If someone shows, go get him, and that's exactly what they did.
Here's Smith now on second down. End zone caught. Touchdown, Seattle.
Noah Fant, a beast in the red zone with his second touchdown of the game. And the Seahawks have opened up a 2-touchdown lead here in this fourth quarter. And Charles, they continue to have trouble stopping him as he's into the end zone yet again.
Yeah, that's multiple series now that have ended with him in the end zone. A perfect plan on how to utilize him best when they get in close.
Myers connects on the PAT, and it's now 21-7. And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away.
And no thought of bringing this one out. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll begin the drive at the 30. Buffalo offense back out, ready to go. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up 6 the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
A tackle made by Boye Mafe.
He continues to struggle to find a crease to break off a big one and might need to just put that aside and just try and ram his way forward and get what he can.
They'll break the huddle, come up on 2nd and 8 at the 27-yard line. So the shotgun snap to Allen. And they work this well upfield across the 45. Able to find a lot of empty space there, picking up the first down at a 21-yard gain.
He certainly isn't looking at the scoreboard out there, because to me, all he's concerned about is analyzing the field and making most of the time left in this game. Deficit's still there, but he's starting to hit them with some big plays.
Here's Allen on 1st and 10. And complete right side to Cook. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards.
Well, they've certainly had their share of troubles running the football in this one, but this play is almost an extension of the running game right here. They set up the screen, let him work out in space on the perimeter, and he turns it into a big pickup.
First down, and they're going to throw with Allen. And he slides and covers up at the end as he's going to be able to pick up decent yardage.
You know what I like about that play? He didn't try to do too much on first down. He took what the defense gave him, put together a solid gain to bring up 2nd and manageable. Now they have a couple of plays to pick up just a few yards and a new set of downs.
Now Allen. And this is caught. A spectacular one-handed grab there.
Boy, that completion comes with a high degree of difficulty, especially on the catch. Had to look that one in one-handed, able to do so, and ends up picking up a first down as well.
All 3 timeouts remain, but they've got to score quick. It's 1st and 10.
Here's Allen. That is caught by Shakir. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, 2nd and 2. This drive, it's been a good mix. 3 passing plays, 3 runs, hitting on all 3 of those passes, and the last one putting him in the red zone.
So wouldn't you think play action right here? Because you've got the ability and had the ability to run it and throw it. Go play action and take your shot at the end zone.
And this is caught now for a late touchdown. So hold everything here. This one's not over yet. Okay, game on. Don't go anywhere yet. You got a 1-score game now.
probably going to rely on the onside kick coming up.
Yeah, they have to. It's not a high percentage play, but it's better than not having a chance at all. And that's when you put your leapers and your flyers on one side, get that high hop, and hope that one of the guys can come up with it.
And on the other side, get that hands team ready.
No doubt about it.
Extra point by Bass, up and good. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. A little less than 90 seconds to go. This will be an onside kick. And the Seahawks looks like they've recovered. They have. A tough one there. They certainly wanted that when they needed it, but they didn't absolutely have to get it. They still do have three timeouts.
You're exactly right. They had to attempt it. But even though they didn't get it, as you noted, with three timeouts, if they can get these stops on defense, all hope is not lost.
We got to have two hands on the football here as they run on first down. And great blocking downfield as he's got this almost to the 35-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march onto the field. And they'll be looking to build off of a nice drive last time, a drive that really relied on the quarterback.
Making good decisions, distributing the ball well, distributing it accurately, keeping it away from danger. A really nicely run drive.
But now the defense, what adjustments do they need to make in the passing game?
Pass rush, pass rush, pass rush. Whether it's the guys up front, or maybe you bring additional guys, but you've got to disrupt the timing of them throwing the football.
We'll see if they can disrupt it here. Walker with another carry. And down inside the 35, he goes to the 32-yard line. Now the Bills will use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Second and six. Trying the left side with Walker. And a nice stiff arm. It opens room to run. And he is going to have a Seahawks first down. And that should just about do it. The Seahawks in victory formation as they go ahead and take the knee. Down to a knee, here goes Smith, and that should all but do it.
Listen, anytime you take a knee to end a game, that means you've won it. So it doesn't matter whether it's home or on the road, but there's something a little extra special about doing it in front of your home crowd, isn't there?
And the home crowd applauding. They're happy with what they've seen. Chalk this one up in the left-hand column for a win.
Yeah, that's right. Head to the locker room, throw the wristbands in the crowd for the kids, your gloves, your towels. Get to share it with the home team.
Well, you really can't ask for much more than what we just had here. Not only a close game that went down to the wire, Charles, but a clean one, too. No turnovers in this contest.
And I think you're exactly right about that. To me, this is just a pair of offenses trying to find the slightest bit of separation from each other. and they were both hoping that the other side would make the big mistake first. But today, neither side made that mistake. And what we got, a very entertaining game throughout.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. It's a win for the Seahawks here as we say so long from Seattle.